Hey friends, thank you so much for liking my channel, subscribing to it and also sharing my videos. For those who are new, I'm Dr. Aditi Bhatnagar. I'm a physician and a Reiki Grandmaster, a spiritual coach. Today, we are going to talk about how the spoken word, now the spoken word can be verbally spoken or it is the internal chatter, you know, the self-talk that we have continuously. You know, we are having a certain discussion in our mind with our own selves or with people, this spoken word and also the visuals that are thrown up in our mind. Whenever you think about, you know, the best vacation you had, suddenly, you know, your mind throws up some visuals of, you know, times, the time you spent when you were on a vacation. Or, you know, if you say that, okay, you know, when was your child's PTM, how was it? Who was the best teacher? Or who was your best teacher? How was your time during school? So there are visuals thrown up in your mind. Now, these visuals have the power to create emotions. And emotions, over a period of time, either they get locked up in your body, they are stored in your body, in the organs, in the muscles, in the tissues, cellular memory, or they are free flowing if they are new or you are sort of experiencing it. For example, as I just said that, you know, which was your best vacation and you suddenly remember your best vacation, the time you spent there, and suddenly there are emotions of happiness which are free flowing also. They are stored in your cells, but they are still free flowing at the moment. So these visuals and the spoken words, they have the power to create emotions, and each and every unit in our body responds to emotion. It stores emotion and it acts on emotion. So the next time you say that this exam pressure is killing me, or this project or this meeting, you know, the impending meeting is really killing me and I really don't know what to do. I feel that I'm not moving ahead in my life. Whenever you say these words, there are certain emotions that are generated. There are certain visuals that are thrown up. And it might all crystallize to aches and pains in your body, maybe leg pains, maybe you have pain in your shoulders, and you know, suddenly you feel very, very, you know, stuck up in your head. You just feel that, you know, there's so much of confusion. These words, these images can actually create diseases. And that's why Reiki is very dear to me. Of course, it's a beautiful healing technique. It's a beautiful practice, you know, to be in that energy. But once you learn Reiki, you realize how easily and gently Reiki sort of maneuvers you from all the negativity, and it helps you touch your own divinity within. If you haven't learned Reiki, do intend to learn Reiki very soon. And if you have already learned Reiki, do join in my session where I'm going to teach you a lot more techniques on how to empower your Reiki. Over a period of more than 2 decades, I have, you know, sort of learned a lot of techniques by reading, by seeing, and also by, you know, doing my own 2+2 kind of a thing. We kind of, you know, mix 2-3 therapies, or we feel that let's do like this and see, and it works wonders. So there are a certain techniques which I have learned in my, as I said, in my time of practice. And I will be sharing that with you in my session. Do join in so that you are able to heal yourself in a much more powerful manner, and also send long distance Reiki energy to your friends and family effectively. Bye bye and see you.